Friday, February 3rd. I'm Jordan Bognowski.
And I'm Dylan Arms.
And you're watching CTV. Here's Kat with more on the story.
Youth for Christ was first brought to Coronado High School in 2009 by Mr. Sattelmeyer, located in D26.
I created Youth for Christ that way we could let the students know about Jesus Christ and who he is and the sacrifice that he made.
So we have about 2,500 students that meet on a weekly basis at various middle schools and high schools across the city. And I just think it's a beautiful thing to be able to be a part of this larger group that has a purpose of impacting the city in a positive way and engaging the youth in that process.
Today, they have meetings every Mondays for B-Lunch in the auditorium of B1.
Well, I was really, I was interested in helping and like getting in touch with students that, you know, are strong in their faith or maybe want guidance in their faith. And I'm really involved in my home church, so I just wanted to be able to help students here at Coronado.
Because I really wanted to search for, you know, the truth, and I was already born in a Christian lifestyle, and I really wanted to search for Christ more.
I was a student leader my senior year of high school, and then I started interning with Youth for Christ El Paso this year.
Just work in some of these students' lives, because I know a lot of these students, they get lonely, they get depressed, they get sad, and I mean, there's people that care about them, you know, like I care about them. People at the club care about them.
My name is Catalina Ramos, reporting for CTV. Back to you.
After this commercial break, we'll have sports with Aiden.
It might seem crazy what I'm about to say. Sunshine, she's here, you can take a break. I'm a hot air balloon that could go to space.
Red light ahead.
I see it.
Logan, you can't be on your phone and driving. That's illegal.
I'm fine.
Logan, slow down. There's a speed bump.
Oops.
That's a horrible parking job.
Want to learn from the best? Go to Sun City Driving School located on North Mesa and Colony Cove 2.
Hi, this is Aiden Ehrlich with sports. The girls' basketball team is in the middle of their season. Here's Gabe with the story.
The girls' basketball team is off to a rough start this year with few remaining seniors. With the varsity consisting of more underclassmen, it's been a challenge, but they have been working through it very well with early morning practices.
It's been really fun, but it's also really difficult because like a lot of the girls that are on my team haven't played. We've only had like two returning varsity players, and so everyone else is like super new and they're very young. We have a lot of sophomores, and so for them it's like really hard to like adjust because like the varsity speed is a lot different and the physicality as well. And like the girls really put in like the work and the time to try to get better and like do whatever they can to like improve themselves and like improve whatever they have to do to get us to win.
The few remaining seniors have really stepped up to help underclassmen fulfill the legacy of the girls basketball team.
We've had our ups and downs during the season, so it really varies, but we're trying to get to a level where we're just continuously playing at our best.
My team in as a whole is like very new, and it's really hard for them to adjust and stuff, but I think like next year and the years after they'll have like a lot more experience, and so they'll be able to like play a lot harder and just win a lot more games.
The seniors are going to be a really big impact. Losing Neha and Santina is going to be a loss because they've been in the program for so long and they help us out with everything and they are really good leaders, but that just gives a chance for other people to step up and lead the team.
Make sure to come support the basketball team. This is Gabriel Arredo reporting from CTV. Back to you.
In other sports news, the tennis team is off to a great start for the spring season. Also, the boys basketball team is playing Franklin tonight at 7:30. That's all for sports. Back to you.
The Japanese club has had a strong following at Coronado for the past couple of years and is always looking for new members. Here's Amelia with more on the story.
Ever since the Japanese club has said konnichiwa, it has encouraged more and more people to join and learn more about the culture.
Well, I joined the club because ever since I was in middle school, actually, I always had a really big interest in Japanese, in the language and the culture. And so I thought like it was just kind of another step further into being immersed into that culture after also like obviously being in Japanese.
I think people should join because they can get an insight into Japanese culture and like the different types of food that they have, like the Japanese candy.
I think my favorite thing about Japanese club is like the amount of friendship and camaraderie that grows on people. Like I've gotten to know a lot of different people and I've gotten to be with my friends, and selling candy is pretty fun, like after school and doing all the activities that are involved in the club.
It's a nice after school activity. You get to like see a little more into the Japanese culture. It's a good way to spend time.
I joined the Japanese club because I'm really interested in Japanese culture, and I thought it would be a really fun after school activity to do.
We haven't really learned much about like the language wise, because that's more sticking towards like the class. But I have learned a lot about the culture, such as certain little things they do, such as the wear, and like origami and food and stuff like that.
My favorite candy would be like the giant Pockies, because Pockies are amazing.
They get their candy from the Wan Jia Lee supermarket, which is somewhere where they sell authentic Japanese food.
We use the money, obviously like a portion of it goes to the school, and then the other part that we fundraise is used at the end of the year where we do a banquet at Koze, and we all just pretty much gather there and eat.
I'm Amelia, and that's it from Japanese Club. Sayonara!
From all of us here at CTV,
thanks so much for watching,
and have a great weekend.